Calling is a live presentation of CBC Sports.
This picture was taken May 26th, but for fans in Edmonton, the negative failed to surface till August. That day, in a trade to top all trades, 99 became a Crown Corporation. The reaction was uniform. It was a black day for Edmonton and L.A. On October the 6th, Wayne Gretzky debuted as the Los Angeles King, and hockey went Hollywood at the Fabulous Forum. Since his great showing that evening, all fans have set their sights on this night and the much-awaited Gretzky homecoming at the Northlands Coliseum in Edmonton.
Every other game I've ever gone into, I've disliked who I'm playing against because I wanted to win. It's tougher in this situation because I know all the players, but I'd still like to win.
A game with 99 reasons to watch, including the great one, Wayne Gretzky.
Molson Hockey Night in Canada on CBC. Canadian, what beer's all about.
Well, here we are. There are 840 games in the NHL regular season, but only one that will mean a lot to people right now, and that's the game this evening at the Northlands Coliseum at Edmonton. Good evening, and welcome to Molson Hockey Night in Canada on CBC. I'm Ron McLean. Just a bit of business right off the top. We've just heard the starting lineup for tonight's game, and Robbie Fatorik is not placing Wayne Gretzky at center ice for the Los Angeles Kings. However, Marty McSorley will be on the right side. There is no doubt there's not an empty seat in the house. There won't be an empty eye in the house. And the reason for this show this evening is 99, Wayne Gretzky. Our cameras are on the LA dressing room, and we'll follow Gretzky to the ice. And we have no idea what to expect in terms of a reaction, but it is a gala homecoming for the great one. Chris Cuthbert is with me. Chris, it seems like only yesterday the fans are beginning to clap and chant now that we were here for May of the Stanley Cup. We all know what happened then. You live in this city. How about an Edmonton perspective on what's happening here?
Well, I think we can feel it right now. This is just like a Stanley Cup final game. It's really hard to define what Wayne Gretzky has meant to the city of Edmonton over the last 9 years. As you see, Wayne Gretzky and the LA Kings coming out of the dressing room. But you know, they wanted to erect a statue or name a street after Wayne Gretzky. But I think the true heartfelt show of emotion we're going to hear from the Northlands Coliseum fans is what Gretzky will cherish and remember the most.
We'll have a watch on this standing O, and it is about to take place here at the Northlands Coliseum. He's entering the ice area right now.
What a moment. ovation has gone 2.5 minutes, and it seems to be rebuilding here at the Northlands Coliseum. You know, they introduced the Oilers as they came out, as is the custom, Harry Neal. No doubt who the cheers were for.
Well, that's a great tribute to the greatest player that probably has ever played the game. And I think you can see the emotion and the true love for this guy in Edmonton.
Here are the stars that remain for the Oilers, the men that have to pick up the slack.
They may do it on the ice as far as stats are concerned, but can they do it in the leadership department? I don't know.
A couple of youngsters who have a lot of pressure on them.
I wish they'd let Carson be Carson and not Gretzky's replacement.
And, of course, great goaltending, always an Oiler trademark. Now with their thoughts on the homecoming, let's go upstairs to join Bob Cole and Don Cherry.
To go here at the Northlands Coliseum, the officials to center ice, and they are the referee there, Don Kuharski, and with him on the lines, Swede Knox and Randy Mitten, the goaltenders tonight. Glenn Healy started in L.A. as number two behind Rolly Melanson. Some think he's already taken over as number one. At the other end, yes, it's Grant Fuhr. Wayne Gretzky himself says he's the best goaltender in the world. And now here he is. For the first time, he's got to figure out how to beat him. Harry, we're set. McTavish, Lacombe, and Adams are starting for Edmonton. Allison, McSorley, and Fenton, the forward line for the L.A. Kings. That's Adams being bumped near center. Lacombe is in. Lacombe couldn't go around Kennedy, and he takes over for Los Angeles. He was bumped to the ice, though, by Greg Adams. First goal. You know they're tense, both teams. Here's McSorley. He's a favorite here. McSorley throws it through the crease. Kennedy is moving up on the right side. Tried to knock it in there and could not. Back of the net. Into the corner. Fenton failed to move it out front. Now it's back near the line, and Lacombe went after it. He goes as far as center, and the play is called. And here's the penalty right off the bat against the Edmonton Oilers.
A high-sticking penalty, and here comes Wayne Gretzky for his first shift as the enemy.
They gave him a four-minute standing ovation before the game, and we're going to get up again, folks, and why not? He has meant so much to this city, to this country, and to this hockey team here, and he's going to mean so much to Los Angeles. Well, they appreciate Wayne Gretzky, and they're on their feet here again at the Coliseum for 99 in black and silver.
Well, he's going to give them a little taste of what all of us used to get a taste of way too often, his great hockey ability. And I wonder if these Oilers fans will cheer if he's in on the first L.A. goal.
You can count on that. And he'd love to be in on the first one. Huddy is in the penalty box. Wayne Gretzky, 99, is on the ice. He has Carpenter, number 11. And another sharpshooter, Robitaille. Tonelli is up there also, and he'll try to dig it out of the corners. Tonelli is wearing number 27. Gretzky on a power play. The L.A. Kings are moving it up to the line, and Tonelli grabs it. Threw it in over the line, but Carpenter was offside. And the play is Edmonton clearing the zone. Playing at the center, Jimmy Carson. Wow, would this be something for him to score? Score! Carson set it up. Anderson gets the goal. And the fans at the Northland Coliseum are on their feet again, but for a different reason.
Well, Brent Anderson scores his first goal of the season in his seventh game on a real smart play by Jimmy Carson. The knock on Carson is he doesn't skate too well, but you can't prove it by this rush. He drops the puck, and Anderson gets all of it to stick it by Glenn Healy up in the top corner. Here's another look at it. Watch the drop pass, and watch the time Anderson's got. Both L.A. players go after Carson, allowing Anderson to walk right to the top of the circle.
Oilers go in there again. They're up 1-0 on that goal at 3:25. Anderson's first of the season. And Mike Allison was back covering, but it's still inside the line. Joseph tried his shot. That is blocked. The Kings try to move up. Into center is Mike Allison across the line. Allison driving it. Score! Gibson skating better than I've ever seen him skate, Harry. Zicking it around in the backhand and set that one up, and we're tied.
And Marty McSorley, a favorite player from here, steals a bit of thunder from Wayne Gretzky and scores the first goal. A nice play by Allison. A bad play by the L.A. left defenseman, who does not take McSorley going to the net. And McSorley, who's a tough guy to take when he decides to go to the net, walks in and gets a perfect pass from Mike Allison. And you can see Huddy